And welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Austin Hernandez is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. Austin from the two. And down he goes at the 29. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Throws a strike over the middle. Tackle around the 50-yard line.
You know, I talked to so many college quarterbacks who have gone on to be very successful in the NFL, and they all talk about the execution of the play action. And all of them talk about, the good ones, about taking their time and really working to sell the play action and sell the fake. If you don't take the time as a quarterback to really sell the fake, it's going to make it easy on the linebackers and safeties to realize that that was just a fake handoff and to get back in position. But when you really work it and sell it the way that quarterback did right there, that's when it's more effective. It can open up the big play.
Nice run up the middle.
Gain of 5 yards.
Roger, Roger.
That brings up second and five.
Drop deep.
Here we go.
East. Eagle.
Check 99.
He scrambles, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
From the 36-yard line, it's third down. Zips it to the back, and he's tackled at about the 29-yard line. Down at about the 15-yard line.
Sanchez on the tackle at the 15-yard line. That makes
it
first and 10.
Ward on the handoff.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Looking for 6, and he got it. Touchdown. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
Once he gets those jets on, there wasn't going to be anything that could stop it. And he adds the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 70-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Johnson takes it right side. They'll bring him down around the 24-yard line.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
From their own 24-yard line. Second down. 5 wide. There he goes. Nice grab on the play. Tackle made at about the 37-yard line. Taken down at the 36.
That is a massive 1 yard on the play. That makes it second and 10.
He's got it with room to run. He's at midfield. He's out of bounds right around the 42-yard line. They come out in a five-wide set. Makes it to the 34. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Tackled for a loss.
Loss of six on the play. That'll make it 39.
From the 40-yard line, third down. Man can't tack on any yardage. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Texas Tech is up by a touchdown. Strike to his receiver, no good.
The quarterback has to be very careful, Brad, of throwing the football into a position where the wide receiver has a chance to get his head taken off. He threw the ball there, and it made it easy for the defender to be able to separate him from the ball.
Quick out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 35-yard line. They were very fortunate to come up with that pass.
Not the smartest throw that he could have made, but it worked. It just makes you a little nervous when he lets that thing go.
Out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
Gain of five on the play. That brings up second and five.
Fires out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 41-yard line.
Nichols keeps him down at the 41-yard line. That'll make it
35.
Wants to go long and does. And he's hit immediately. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. The Red Raiders with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Across the middle. Finds a man. Touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator. What great catch by the wide receiver, and the guy who needs to be thanking him is the quarterback. That's not where he wanted that ball to go, but the receiver made the catch and saved the quarterback for a touchdown.
And he hits the PAT. It was a six-play, 81-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Fielded at the four. At the 30. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Now he tries to buy some time. He's to the 40, slides down, and that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
Run, and he's he's brought down.
That's a gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
Three down.
Help! Ruin! Ruin!
Check!
He's scrambling. And he's sacked.
Loss of one on the play. That makes it third and seven.
Three down.
Court is the mark. Freeze. Check. Oklahoma.
Check.
Looks middle. Got his back. And they make the stop at the 41.
If you're the defense coordinator, you got to be frustrated with the way your defense gave up that first down. The defense has got to do a better job of recognizing the screen and then chasing it down from behind, especially the defensive linemen. They've got to see whether it's the quarterback or the offensive lineman to tip the screen and then help the rest of the defense be able to slow that play down and not give up that first down.
He's tackled
around the 32-yard line.
He's at the 20. Makes it out to about the 16.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
From the 16-yard line, it's first down. Pitches back, and now he's got room to run.
Runs right for a nice gain.
Quick throw out to the receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal. It's the ninth play of the drive.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Touchdown, USF! And that was a perfectly executed play there by the offense.
And the option is so tough to defend, especially right near the goal line.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A nice 9-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
South Florida lines up for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Texas Tech is up 7. Man tackled for a loss. The Red Raiders will use their first time out of the half. From their own 19-yard line, it's second down. And he is drilled at the 33.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Pulls it in and gets out of bounds.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That's a game of 20 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle at the 33-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
All day, every day, any day. Ready!
Easy.
Delta!
Switch!
Delta!
Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
They'll line it up again on third down. Tries to pitch it, and now the ball is loose. It's recovered. Think about that last turnover, Kirk.
Way to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. And he's going to be sacked. Here comes the pressure. He goes downtown. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender. Fourth down.
Hernandez awaits the snap. He's tackled at the 31. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Texas Tech is up a score. He chucks it downfield. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Throws it deep. Can't connect.
Incomplete. Number two was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and ten.
Steps up. He airs it out. And he's tackled at about the 17-yard line. We played a half of football. Texas Tech in front, 14-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
I love this first half. Two defenses that will flat stick their face in the fan. I mean, there was some hitting going on out there. Good, clean, tough football in the first half. Much like you experienced, David, there was almost a magic number for your teams at Georgia. If you got to a certain number of points, the game was over.
Yeah, I was there for my 4 years, when our team scored over 17 points, we were undefeated. So when you have a great defense, first of all, you have high expectations. You expect to come in and shut the opponent out. And the offense on the other side, you know what you got too. You don't have to go out there and try to fling it around the yard and score 30 points a game. You don't have to put a lot of pressure on yourself. You just execute the plays that are in front of you and realize that punts aren't going to kill you. I got a dominant side of the football. Play towards that strength. Don't shoot myself on the foot on the other side of the football.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Number 13, back deep to return.
He's to the 20. Oh, he got nailed on that one. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts.
and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. Is out to the tailback on the screen. They bring him down in the backfield.
That was a loss of 3 yards. That brings up fourth and seven.
Certainly, they don't have the return on here. He makes it to the 45-yard line.
Woo, defense, let's go! Let's go!
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Texas Tech up 7 points. Complete. He's got room. Brought down right around the 44-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. The senior makes the catch. Very good tackle in space.
Called a gain of 13 yards. First down.
Ready.
Pulls it in and he's in the open field. That's a great tackle at the 23.
Abraham with the tackle at the 23-yard line. That brings up second and one.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. And he throws it away. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Throws, and that one's going to hit the ground. Incomplete.
Number two, the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and one.
Inside the 10. They'll bring him down around the 3-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Red Raiders. So they punch it in on the ground, Kirk Herbstreit.
Great job up front by the offensive line. They get a good, strong push that allowed the runner to get it in there for the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Hatfield has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 3. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Texas Tech's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made at the 40. Taken down at the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Stay down. Right line. 2 for 2.
his way to the 36-yard line.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Check 9, check 9. Time to go night, night.
Check that, Texas.
Quick out to his receiver. He's taken down right around the 26-yard line. He goes out of bounds at the 21.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Caught out of the open. And he shoved out of bounds at the 13-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 13. And down he goes at the 13.
No gain. That makes it 2nd and 10.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. He makes it out to maybe the 10-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Touchdown, South Florida.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he adds the extra point. So with one quarter remaining, Texas Tech in front, 21-14. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Austin from the 3. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop at about the 33-yard line. Texas Tech is up by a touchdown. He's under pressure. Fires incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires incomplete, knocked away. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Gets to about the 41-yard line.
Returns for a gain of 10 yards.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. He's going to try and scramble. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's at the 40, at the 30, to the 20. He's tackled around the 15-yard line. The ball here and brought down in the backfield.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
Three down.
Let's go. Hey,
Nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
Right, right, right.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Three down. Mike 40, check, check.
Hey, man. Hey, Oklahoma.
No.
Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
Wilcox is the intended receiver on the play.
And it's the offense that takes the field on 4th down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's on the run. And he breaks a tackle, and now he's got room to run.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point.
A 5-play, 58-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Hernandez has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Austin from the 8. Tackle at the 36. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
There's a lot of time left, and I think the important thing for this offense is to get their momentum back and move the ball down the field.
We might have overtime in the back of our minds, but down in the field, that hasn't occurred to anyone. They want to end this thing in regulation.
Makes the catch, and look out. Tackle at the 47-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. First down.
Slings it. And he's tackled at the 44.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
He's got it with room to run. Brought down at the 34.
First down.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter.
Let's go!
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He gets hit out of bounds. Around the 27-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Quick throw out to the receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal, fourth quarter, all tied up. What's it going to be? They'll bring him down at about the 3-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That brings up second and goal.
Touchdown, Texas Tech. They had to dig deep to score here that late in the fourth quarter and come from behind. And now the question is, can their defense dig in and win it for them? And he hits the PAT. So that's a 7-play, 64-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and receiver.
The score now, 28-21. And he's tackled at the 41. The Bulls have played poorly all day long. That really doesn't matter right now.
They've played sloppy. They're not going to be happy when they go back and look at the film on Monday. But with all that being said, they still have a chance to win this game. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters. You're trying to get that W.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. South Florida will take their first time out of the half. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Gets it. He's in space. And he hits him hard at the 48-yard line. The Bulls call a timeout. That's their second of the half. The grab, and he's got the first tackle made at the 42. Scrambling around, decides to slide.
That makes it second and six.
And he stops the clock with a spike. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. He lets it fly. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
Number eight, the intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
Well, you never know what can happen in college football, so I wouldn't be surprised by anything here. Either way, it should be exciting. Wants to go long and does. Wow, you just got to love it for this defense. They come up with the stop of the ball game and maybe the season. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 28-21, Texas Tech.
The Bulls, 21.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.